Hey, what's going on everyone? DJ TV here, and thank you so much for clicking on today's video. Today, we are gonna go over my Elimination Chamber 2020 prediction, and we're just gonna hop right into it. And I don't know, man, it's not looking like a good, you know, like a pay-per-view so far. But anyway, let's hop into it. We got Daniel Bryan versus Drew Gulak. man, I don't know. This one could go any way. I'm going to go with Daniel Bryan. Why? It's obvious because it's Daniel Bryan. And I don't know. Drew winning this match would actually be quite huge for him, pinning a former World Heavyweight Champion. the U.S. title is on the line. This just got thrown in. CN is taking on... I should have written down his name. But let's just say Cousin. this match should be good because they're actually both fantastic wrestlers. You know, especially CN being like Eddie 2.0. But I think CN is definitely going to retain this title and lead up to a match for WrestleMania in the Fatal 4-Way. Next up, we got the Intercontinental Championship on the line in the handicap match. Yeah, which is weird. How is this going to work out? I don't know. So, Braun is putting his IC title on the line against Shinsuke, Cesaro, and Sami Zayn. And it just, how's this going to work? So, whoever pins Braun just becomes a champion? Interesting. I'm interested to see how this is going to turn out. And what type of match Braun is going to have at WrestleMania for the Intercontinental Championship if he retains, which I highly, you know, strongly believe he's going to retain the Intercontinental Championship. It's really interesting to see what they're going to do here. Will Shinsuke win it back? Will Cesaro win it? Will Sami Zayn win it? Because we haven't seen Sami Zayn fight in a long time. But I think Braun is definitely going to retain against these three guys. next, we have the Raw Tag Team titles on the line as the new Raw Tag Champs, the Street Profits, defend their titles against Seth Rollins and Buddy Murphy. This should be good. You know, actually, their match on Raw for the tag titles was actually good, and I actually enjoyed it. So I am looking forward to this one. You can't go wrong at all, actually. And to be honest with you, they all are fantastic in the ring. You know, you got Seth Rollins there, man. Come on. He's the best that they got right now. Buddy Murphy's fantastic. And you got the Street Profits. They are entertaining, and they are very watchable. So, yeah. With this one, I think the Street Profits are going to retain the tag titles and maybe eventually later have Authors of Pain go up against them, but we'll talk about that at the end of this video. But I think the Street Profits are gonna retain. Now, the Elimination Chamber. Oh boy, here we go. We got the SmackDown Tag Team titles on the line. The Miz and John Morrison will be defending their tag team titles against 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 other teams. We got Bobby Roode, Dolph Ziggler, The Usos, Heavy Machinery, Lucha House Party, and The New Day. I think Miz and Morrison is going to retain the tag team championships and hold them till WrestleMania or probably throughout the whole entire WrestleMania and still hold them for a while. Because right now they are a hot thing going. And I just don't see... Well, I can see Heavy Machinery probably winning it too. But I think they're probably just going to have a regular thrown-in match somewhere at WrestleMania. But I'm going to go with John Morrison and The Miz all the way to retain their titles. Next, we have a no disqualification match. Aleister Black versus AJ Styles. I'm definitely interested in this one. I'm looking forward to this one because these two are my favorites in the company today. And it's a no DQ, so anything can go. You know, the club can interfere in this match, attack Aleister Black, help AJ win, or anything. Will The Undertaker show up? I don't know. I highly doubt it. I really do. But it would be awesome to see Undertaker just, like, interfere and, like, do something with AJ Styles to really push him to get this match at WrestleMania. But we need something for Aleister Black, man. This guy, I love Aleister. He needs to be a strong superstar that WWE has. You know, that's what when he lost on Raw against AJ Styles. It's AJ Styles, so I don't know. This match would go either way. So that's like equal to me. I can't have a winner. pretty sure this is the main event. We got the Women's Elimination Chamber. Whoever wins will go to WrestleMania to face Becky Lynch. So we got, oh my gosh, I can't even say their names. We got Natalya, Liv Morgan, Shayna Baszler, Asuka, Asuka, Mandy, no, not Mandy Rose. we got, what's her name? Oh gosh. Sarah Logan and Ruby Riott. Sorry about that, guys. I was just drawing a blank here. Oh my gosh, what is going on? but with this match, it actually can wind up being good, especially since Liv Morgan and Ruby Riott been going at it with each other in this past few weeks. We got Shayna Baszler, hands down. Definitely my pick is Shayna Baszler. I want to see the match against Becky Lynch. I know a lot of people again disagree, but I personally want it. So it should be an interesting chamber to see. Well, all right, guys, that is my Elimination Chamber 2020 predictions. Of course, let me know down in the comments below who you guys think is going to win, who's going to walk out the chamber victorious, and head on to WrestleMania. So what's going to happen? I'm not too sure. Anything could go. Like with Braun Strowman, what is he going to do for Mania? The tag team champions, what's going to happen for Mania? Because right now, we don't know exactly what is going on. That's why we need more stories, more feuds to lead up to good matches at WrestleMania. I hate when they throw things together. I really do. I feel like this year's Elimination Chamber didn't get much attention as it should. Because this is the last pay-per-view before WrestleMania. So, like, this is it. So, if you guys noticed, no world titles is being defended. WWE Heavyweight Championship or the Universal Championship. Which is weird. So, we will see what's going to happen at Elimination Chamber. Like I said, I don't think Undertaker is going to show up for AJ. But probably Raw, he will. But other than that, I don't see nothing other big happening as well. You know, it's crazy. But thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed. Don't forget to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. See you guys next time.